Welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today we're going to have a really fun experiment, and I'm going to show you exactly what I have planned for the future up at my place up in Northern Ontario. I've got an off-grid place, and I'm going to try this experiment. I've never seen anybody do it before, but I'm going to do it. It's going to be a little bit of a long-term experiment. Hopefully I'll get this built this year, but let's take a look at what I'm doing here and see if you can follow along with the idea that I have, and hopefully I think I can do it. So let's take a look. Well, let's start off right here. This is not a point of use hot water tank. It's actually a 2.5-gallon hot water tank, and it just runs off 110, 120 volts, and it draws around 1400 watts. That is what I'm going to install up at my camp. And let's get to this unit right here. I'm going to be using a fan, and I've got this temperature controller here. This is quite interesting. I just started to set it up now. Going to have to measure exactly what the milliamp draw is on it, including the fan and without the fan. And we're going to see exactly what the temperature in here today is. I've got my power supply, 12 volt power supply, and we are going to get this experiment on the go here. And what I'm planning on doing is having a larger water tank outside of my building, but I'm going to use this fan to go through my block wall building into an outside insulated box where my 25 gallon storage tank of water is, where it has a pump on it, a 12 volt pump. And this charge controller, this little temperature controller will operate the fan. So the fan will take the air from inside my cabin, blow it through the block wall into where my water tank is with my 12 volt pump, and this will go on at a temperature that is above freezing, and it'll shut off when it gets up to a preset temperature, whatever I select. And we're going to test this all out here to see if it works in theory. And I picked these up, I couldn't believe it, like $6 each, so I got two of them. So let's get started right now, and we'll start off with the temperature controller, and I'll show you how that works. Okay, so let me just explain before we get started here. So all I got is my power wire coming in and my ground, and this is my two exit leads. So this is my ground and this is my power for whatever your supply source is, whatever you want to run, which would be the fan. And this here is a small little pellet that's a temperature sensor, and that is taking the outside temperature. So if we just take a look here at my, see if I can point to something that's metal here. So you could tell there's a temperature there, and it's registering what, 10.6. What do we got here? So around 10.6. This is 11.5. So it's, well, temperature fluctuates. Anyways, right here where the pellet is, it's showing 10.2. So the thermometer is a little bit off, but it's not that critical as long as it's close. And the whole idea behind this is, as the temperature drops, it'll come to a pre-select point. So if you take a look here, I've selected 12.4. So 12.4 is actually above the room temperature now. And the cutoff temperature I selected was 16 degrees. And that's when it will shut off. So let's just start this up, and I'll show you exactly the theory behind it. Okay, so the fan is on because, and let me just zoom you in a bit there. There. Okay, so the fan is on because it is dropped down below the threshold, right? So now let me just put my finger on it here, and you'll see the temperature going to start to rise. And it'll, there it is, just over 16, it shut off. And that's exactly what I wanted, and this fan pushes just over 50 cubic feet per minute, and that will actually send all the hot air that's inside the cabin to the outside water tank and prevent it from freezing. So now let's measure and see how many milliamps this whole system is drawing. Well, I'll just start the power supply up. There we go, 12.5 volts. And it looks like 74, we're gonna call that 75 milliamps. And of course, the fan is not running. I realized in the last shot you couldn't see the fan running or not. But, so what we'll do is we'll see exactly what it's gonna start up at with the fan. So I'll touch these two wires together. There goes the fan on. And it looks like it's going to draw 285. Now that will go down. You know, these fans are like over time, they kind of drop. So now if I just go with my other hand here and grab a hold of this pellet. There, see it shut off once it got above the 16. So let me just reset this. Well, that seems to be different, but look at the temperature there. So it's in the off state. See, now it's in the off state. It's only using 22 milliamps. But when it's on the on state, it's up around 75. So that's very interesting. Okay, so you see it's right here. So it's not going to turn on. Now, what I want to do is figure out, if I turn the power off completely, will it remember my settings? So let's just disconnect the power, put the power back on, 12.4, which is the correct temperature for the lowest temperature on, and 16. So there you go, this is going to work perfectly. Well, this is the hot water tank that I chose, and it's a 2.5-gallon hot water tank. And the whole idea behind this whole project is I do have a 25-gallon tank with a 12-volt pump on it already. I'm going to show that in the future. And I haven't built the enclosure for it, but I figure it's going to be about 16 cubic feet inside. So if you take a look at this fan here, that'll blow 50 cubic feet a minute. Well, you can tell that it's not going to take that long for it to take the heat from inside the cabin and blow it inside the insulated box just to make sure that it doesn't freeze. Because so many times we go up the first week of November, yeah, minus 10, minus 15 degrees. And this is all in Celsius. And of course, once you freeze the pipes, well, of course, you got no more water. And the whole idea behind this is I have inside the cabin now a 5-gallon container that I use for my water. But I'd like to be able to start using some hot water. So I'm going to take that tank, put it underneath my sink, and run the lines outside and run all the electrical to my main panel that I have for my solar battery panel that charges my batteries up. And of course my 120 volt hot water tank is going to run off my generator. So now this is all happening because I'm trying to put in a new well, and I'll put a link down below for that series on me, you know, going through this whole well procedure and starting off from the beginning. And I'm going to make my own well going into the ground and pumping a lot more water than I have now, which will allow me to have more, of course, hot water. So when it comes down to it, this particular system here, I like the idea that I can turn it off and it retains the memory. That is ideal. So when it's in its standby mode, it's only 20 milliamps,
And when it's actually on, it's about 75. And then of course, when the fan is on, the whole thing altogether is about a quarter of an amp. And how long is that gonna be running? I'm gonna guess maybe 30 seconds at a time. And that is gonna be ideal for me. So I hope you like this little bit of a series that's gonna be going on. I'll put some links down below so you can follow along. And this is gonna be quite interesting how I take the air from inside the cabin, blow it outside into an insulated container where I have my 25-gallon water tank, and everything runs so smooth in the future, having a lot more water, having some hot water. Because the way it is now, if I want hot water, I gotta put a kettle on top of the stove or put it on top of my wood stove and heat up some water. It's gonna be nice to be able to just have some hot water on demand, and 2.5 gallons I think will be plenty. I got a lot of wiring to do, a lot of plumbing to do, and a lot of thinking to do. So thanks for joining me here today. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. Follow along for this northern adventure. Cheers.